Hello everyone. Hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
Hi. My name is Sanjay. I am the co-founder and the CEO of Urban Air Lab. Our product name and the brand name is Rubri. And today I am here to talk about air pollution. What is this air pollution problem? What is the impact of the air pollution problem on our health? What is the importance of healthy and good air quality? And what we can learn from the nature while we try to mitigate the issue. So firstly, let's talk about air pollution. So air pollution by definition means any harmful substance that can come in the air that we breathe that can cause health problems to us. So that we call as air pollution. So all the harmful substance that can get into the air, these are typically called air pollutants, broadly categorized in dust particle pollution, gaseous pollution, biological pollution. Even COVID-19, when it came, COVID was also a type of air pollution when we talk about the airborne viruses and bacteria which can come in the air and we can get infected through that. And air pollution broadly can be categorized into two broad categories. So one is outside air pollution and then the indoor air pollution. So can someone guess what would be the air quality in Gwalior right now, today? Anyone? Good, bad, not so good? So air quality is measured by Air Quality Index, AQI. AQI is an overall score which is measured from 0 to 500. And that tells you what is the air quality levels in your city, in your conference room, in your auditorium. So 0 to 50 is something that we call as healthy air quality. And beyond 50, there are more categories, moderate air pollution, high level of air pollution sensors. But overall, it is not healthy. So today in Gwalior, AQI levels are roughly around 90 to 120. So you can categorize that as a moderate level of air pollution. And Delhi, as you know, some of you might know, is called the capital of air pollution in India as well, because in Delhi most of the time the air pollution index, air quality index, remains beyond 200 and 300. So that's air pollution. More on indoor air pollution. So most of us think that the air pollution is outside. When we get indoors, when we get into this auditorium, the air quality would be better. But most research tells us that indoor air quality can be a bigger problem, because in indoor we not only have to deal with the outside air pollution but also a lot of man-made air pollution problems as well. So for example, in this auditorium, because we have a very compact and airtight auditorium, so whatever the air pollution is being created inside of this auditorium, this will remain inside of this auditorium for a long, long time. And that is why the indoor air pollution becomes a greater challenge. So what do we do about the air pollution problem? So traditionally, air pollution is being treated by mechanical air filters. Mechanical air filters just act as a tea strainer, chai ki chhanni ke jaise, jisme, when you pass the dust particle, the air pollutants through the air filter, the filters will capture those dust particles. But as you can imagine, after a while, these filters will get clogged and you will have to throw these filters somewhere else. And it becomes someone else's problem. So while trying to address a problem, we are creating another set of problems for someone else. So to me, that was not a good solution. That was a pure quick fix solution, and which only talks about the dust particle pollution, not the biological contaminants or maybe the gaseous problems, gaseous pollution problems that we can come across. So with UBRI, what I wanted to do was to find a more sustainable solution which can capture a broad spectrum of air quality, not just focus on the dust particle pollution, and also do not leave any carbon footprint because of what the product or solution is trying to sort of solve. So that is where I started exploring what are the natural ways to clean the air. And India, traditionally, we all know that, you know, since our childhood, we've been told that ghar mein ek tulsi ka pauda laga do, ghar ke paas ek peepal ka ped, and all that. And recently, we've also seen, you know, a lot of indoor plants being sold to us as air purifying plants. So I wanted to check that if there is some merit into that, if there is, you know, anything that we can learn from that. So very quickly, I understood that through these indoor plants, through these plants, the air could be clean, but the impact of these plants is very insignificant. So for example, in this auditorium, if we have to solve air pollution problem just by using plant, we will have to have almost 1,000 to 10,000 of, you know, such plants to have any significant improvement. And that is not practical at all. So that is where our work come into the picture, that is the genesis of our work. We harness the capabilities of a natural plant to clean the air and amplify it by a certain degree by our technology. The technology that we have built, we call it breathing roots technology. So essentially, with breathing roots technology, what we do, we magnify the cleaning happening through one plant by almost 500 times. So which means, if a normal plant is being put into our machine, our solution, it will have the same impact if you had 500 normal plants sitting over here. And that's a massive, massive milestone, massive magnification. Globally also, there are certain companies, certain universities which are working on this specific technology, trying to magnify the cleaning, by using some certain technology. But this level of magnification has never been reached before. So that's a big milestone. Typically, if I take just a quick few seconds to tell you the breathing roots technology in brief. So essentially, the cleaning through plants happens in the soil root zone of the plant. So the air has to go inside of the soil. Inside of the soil, there are certain microorganisms which feed on certain type of gaseous pollutants. And they feed on these gaseous pollutants and they convert it into non-harmful substances. So that is how the cleaning happens normally also to the plants. With our solution, with our technology, this entire process gets amplified by a certain number. And that is why there is a greater impact through one single plant also. So that's, in a gist, is breathing roots technology. Over the years, this is a very new topic. The air pollution topic is a fairly new topic. People are now getting into this topic. So we, over the last 4-5 years, have learned so much, and we have tried to increase our expertise into that as well. So as you can imagine, air quality problems, air pollution problems will be very different from one place to the other place. One auditorium in Gwalior would have different challenges when compared to, let's say, another auditorium in Delhi University, right? So the problem is different, so the solution has to be different for all the different indoor spaces as well. So over the last 4-5 years, we have developed multiple products and multiple solutions to address those issues. Some of the products are being shown over there, which are more specific to, let's say, our typical household in India, or let's say some of the products are more relevant for enterprise solutions or maybe bigger spaces like this one. Quickly, if I take a few minutes to talk about the kind of impact that we've been able to create. One of the projects that we're working upon is in Chennai, where we're working with two public schools, and the idea is that children and elderly people are the ones who are at higher risk from the exposure of the air pollution. Children especially, because they are in the growth stage, and if they are exposed to a certain level of air pollution in the growth stage as well, so the overall development, cognitive development and the physical development will be hampered significantly. So the idea of working in schools was to bring about a case study, bring about the best practices for a public school wherein they can manage the air quality better, what are the different set of processes or do's and don'ts they need to follow. Happy to share that in Chennai, and surprising surprisingly, Chennai is also one of the cities which has a air quality level in the ranges of 200, which was a big surprise to us as well. So happy to share that in these schools we have been able to mitigate the air pollution problem for these school children, and the case study is now going to come out very soon, which will be made available to all the other schools in India so that they can learn from our experiences and maybe adopt a few practices that we have taken. One of the other projects that we worked during the COVID time was to build a negative pressure air ambulance. So one of the problems that government was facing, that when they were trying to move one patient from one place to the other place, there was a high risk of the COVID, airborne COVID particles, getting dispersed into the public area. The contaminants could, hamper the health of other non-COVID patients as well. So the ambulance was designed specifically so that if a COVID patient is traveling by this ambulance, the others would not get these COVID particles, and the COVID airborne COVID particles can be treated within the ambulance itself. So we worked on this ambulance, and there are now more than 10 ambulances which are in function in today's time as well. And similarly, one of the projects that we work is in the IIT Roper, wherein IIT Roper is a very peculiar case. We've been all hearing about the stubble burning problem in Punjab. And IIT Roper campus is situated just at the center of this particular problem. All around the campus are these farms where the farmers, generally burn the stubble, and there is a huge smoke that comes from Punjab and goes to Delhi and all. So IIT Roper has a pollution level beyond 500. I mean, the AQI is measured till 500. After that, the monitor doesn't show you any numbers. But the Roper campus was showing 500 numbers consistently, and we didn't know that, how much more the pollution is. So with this project, we worked with IIT Roper in their guest house, and with our latest product, we were able to solve the air pollution problem by almost 70% just by using nature-based and plant-based air purification technologies. There is no mechanical filter, there is no recording effort, there is no filters being dumped into the dump yard. Just by these plants, the nature-based technologies that we've been working upon, the pollution level were brought down to by almost 70%. So these projects tell us that we are moving in the right direction. There is a future for such technology, and we should always be looking to create sustainable technologies for overall sustainable growth and not just look for quick fix solutions. After COVID, there is a huge surge in the initiatives taken by public and private players, because all of us learned during the COVID time the importance of healthy air quality, the importance of having put on a mask in the public areas, what is the infection that can travel through air, and all those things were learned. So there is a huge surge by all these programs, and there is an emergency which is being created by public and private players both. But while we are trying to sort of come to a solution, come to an awareness level wherein we all understand that the air pollution problem is not just a government's problem, not just a problem for the scientists or the researchers, but it is a cumulative problem. It is a problem of all of us, and all of us are responsible for the problem, and all of us have to sort of take smaller steps within our capacity to mitigate this problem to us and to the society at large. While we all, I'm sure a few of you would get into this space eventually, because this is going to be an important topic for all of us in the near future. So I want to sort of give this message that whenever we work on any kind of technology, we should always focus on overall sustainable growth, not look for quick money, quick fix solution, or maybe this can be used for today, but tomorrow I don't know who will suffer from it. So that has been our approach as well. sustainability, local procurement, Make in India, working with a very social responsibility. So those are some of the principles that we follow in our company, in our work on a daily basis as well. So yeah, so with this message I would like to conclude my talk today. We have to care about the air that we breathe, but we have to prioritize the clean tech solutions or the sustainable solutions over the quick fix solutions, which can cause a bigger problem in the coming time. So yeah, so thank you so much, and I'll be here for some time. I would love to take some questions. So I'll take some questions if anyone wants to have.